Today I'm going to present to you a case of sanctuary lobe of the placenta. Sanctuary lobe of placenta is an accessory lobe of placenta which is situated slightly away from the main placental tissue, and it is important to identify this lobe because in case it is retained at the time of birth, then it may cause postpartum hemorrhage. She is a 20 weeks pregnancy, and you can see that there is a separate lobe of placenta over here. This is a separate lobe of placenta over here, and this is the main placental mass. This is the fundus of the stomach, fundus of the uterus, and the cord is attached over here. I try to show you in this clip, running clip. This is the main. This is the sanctuary lobe, and this is the main placental tissue, and this is the fetus, and here somewhere is the cervix. This is the fundus of the uterus. And this is the sanctuary lobe, which is to be differentiated from the uterine contraction. How do we differentiate this sanctuary lobe from the uterine contraction? Is that you should repeat the ultrasound after 15-20 minutes, and if this lobe and the morphology persist, then you may surely say that this was a sanctuary lobe. Secondly, the sanctuary lobe appears the same in morphology and as that of main placental tissue, while the contraction is likely to appear more hyperechoic. And third most important differentiating feature is that the sanctuary lobe of the placenta will show retroplacental space with some blood vessels, as in this case. Here you can see the retroplacental space. Here also you can see the main blood vessels which are there. The blood vessels are the maternal blood vessels which can be seen behind this sanctuary lobe. While in cases of uterine contraction, these vessels may not be seen. This is the color scan of the same patient. You can see the blood vessels, the metal blood vessels behind the placenta in the retroplacental space, and similarly over here also. And you can see that the sanctuary lobe of the placenta is connected to the main placenta by a small placental tissue or maybe membranes, and it does not have a separate blood supply. The main umbilical cord is attached over here, though the attachment is slightly eccentric to the main placental tissue, and the sanctuary lobe is separately situated, though it is situated at the fundus here, near the fundus in this case. But in case it is situated in the lower lobe, then the blood vessels and the membranes may cross the cervix, and this condition is called as the vasa previa, and it can be dangerous in case the gynecologist or the obstetrician is not aware, because it can give rise to the hemorrhage. At times the gynecologist or the obstetrician is not aware that there is sanctuary lobe and the main tissue of the placenta is expelled. She is under the impression that the whole placenta has been expelled, while the sanctuary lobe remains inside the uterus and causes postpartum hemorrhage. Here we try to look for the vasa previa. The chances of vasa previa in this patient are absolutely nil, because the sanctuary lobe and the main placental tissue both are situated, but here you can see there are hardly any vessels, and the cervix appears to be nearly normal. Sanctuary lobe of the placenta is to be differentiated from the double placenta or a bilobed placenta. In bilobed placenta, both the placental lobes are nearly of the same size, while in the sanctuary lobe, the one lobe is very small in size and the other lobe is very large in size. And in this case the sanctuary lobe is only 4 cm, nearly 5 cm to 6-8 cm in size, while the main placental tissue is large in size. And whenever you see that the bilobed placenta or sanctuary lobe, it is important to look for the twins, and in this case we could not find any twins, so this was a classical case of sanctuary lobe of the placenta. And we have tried to scan the patient in the horizontal scan as well as the vertical scan, but the sanctuary lobe always appeared like a separate small lobe attached to the male placental tissue by a thin rim of placental tissue or maybe membranes. Thank you very much. I hope you liked our video. In case you like our videos, kindly subscribe to our channel, Dr. S.K. Gupta Shivam Nursing Home, and please share the video with maximum number of your friends so that large number of people can be benefited. Thank you very much.